this vaccine was not rushed. It's just a technology that we have right now where we were able to create this vaccine faster. But this vaccine followed the same type of steps that any other type of vaccine was developed before. They have to go to different phases. They have to be tested in animals. They have to test efficacy before the government give them the green light. Now, this vaccine will never fuse to your DNA. RNA and DNA are completely different type of molecules. RNA, when these RNA vaccines comes to your cells, they stay in the cytoplasm. They never go to your nucleus. The nucleus is when you have your DNA protected. So they never see each other. So there's no way this RNA can actually get involved or integrate to your genome. So there's absolutely no evidence. There's no way, at least from the scientist perspective, that this RNA will create any type of mutation or anything on yourself. Let me tell you that it's absolutely nothing like that in these vaccines. Nothing. It's a new technology, but they don't have any type of controlling thing. This is a very safe vaccine. I think you guys are used to, your phones that have chips and GPS. And I think you guys are not afraid because you guys understand how the phone works. So the more we can explain to you how a vaccine is made of, and you understand how the vaccines are safe, I think you're less gonna be concerned about these myths and misinformation. Please don't feel like you're a guinea pig. This vaccine, even though it's, like I said before, it's a new technology, is being tested and retested in animals and in different clinical phases. So it's clearly safe. There's no evidence that you guys are being guinea pigs. The advantage you guys have is that you're living right now. You're gonna be part of this new type of vaccine technology that I'm pretty sure in the future we're gonna develop for all the type of viral infections and even bacterial infections. So I think that we all have to feel proud that we are participating in this type of vaccines and helping advance science and health. Even if we're gonna be vaccinated, that means that we still need to wear our mask because we don't know if we get infected with the virus and we don't gonna get sick, hopefully, or very sick with this vaccine that will protect us. But that doesn't mean we can infect somebody else if we have the virus for a few days. So we need to wear our mask, we need to wash our hands, we need to keep our distance, unfortunately, probably until the fall of next year. But during that time, most of the people should get vaccinated. And after most of the people has the vaccine, we can go back to normality.